Okay, we are live on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, YouTube. I had to think for a second. All right, so I am going to start the timer. If you'll notice, we have a new timer right over here. It's a hippo timer. So when Augustine reaches Nicaea, the Council of Nicaea, then our time is up. So today I'm going to be working on turning this sketch art into final art. I'm going to show you my process for doing that. And before I get started, I'd like to turn your attention to the Westminster Illustrated Catechism, which is available for pre-order at RefToons.com. You can pre-order that now, and we hope to start sending those out in October of this year. So if you are on, if you are wherever you're watching from, feel free to say hi in the comments, ask questions in the comments, and I will answer your questions as I can as I'm working through this illustration. So, oh, one more announcement. We are going to have a RefToons booth at the Fight Laugh Feast in Knoxville. That is coming up in October. So, sorry, I need a drink here. So we will be heading out to Knoxville in October, setting up a RefToons booth at the Fight Laugh Feast. Stephanie and I, and we've only been to one Fight Laugh Feast, which was in South Dakota last year, 2 years ago. I don't remember. One of these years. And it was a really fun conference. Met a lot of great people, and we're looking forward to this year again. So that's the Fight Laugh Feast conference in Knoxville, Tennessee. All right. Let me just make sure all of my things here are situated where I need them to be. Excuse me. Sorry, when I go live, there's a few things that I can only do after I've gone live, so I have to take care of those here. All right, I think we're good. If you can hear me, let me know, and I will start working on this. So this is Herman Newt. He is going to be exploring theology, or we are going to be tagging along as he explores theology. Pardon me, there is just like a dry patch in my throat. Let me get some hot coffee to wash it down. Okay, let's begin. Hope everyone's doing well. Let me know where you're tuning in from also. I'm going to turn a fan on it. There may be a humming noise in the background, but it's much needed if I'm to do this. Okay, so first things first, I need to make these sketches look like the model sheet that I Well, it's not really a model sheet. It's the first design iteration of Herman Nude. I would like I'd like all of these to at least resemble him. That would be nice, because then we know our character and. Oh boy. I don't know what happened to my glove, but my hand is like sticking to the screen here. Oh, I have an idea. Okay, there. Now my hand's gonna slide better. Don Lobos on Instagram says, "Hi. Hello, how are you? Hope you're doing well." Okay, so I need the pencil brush. And I am working in Clip Studio Paint today. Working on this. The Clip Studio Paint is a great program for doing comic book work, because they have a really great comic book panel layout tool that is actually really helpful for laying out panels and doing comics. So I really like using this program, except it takes me a while to find the right pencil brush that I like to use. Paul's pencil, maybe that's it. Could be. Still don't like that one, but sometime I'll make a different brush. So I have this in my sketch is too angular. It should be more rounded and flowy. That's huge eraser brush. I started reading through Charles Hodge's Systematic Theology this morning, looking for different ways in which theologians have defined theology or brought out that definition. And I actually found his systematic theology to be quite helpful. I've really been enjoying it. I think we decided what this type of hat was called in a previous live stream, but I forgot. I forgot what it was called. I just call it an Outback hat. If anyone knows what this hat is called, I would love to hear from you. Get that line going there. Sometimes I don't get the lines quite right, and it ends up like just the slightest variation in the line can make the character not look like the character. So I think I have the pose right. Otherwise, I would. I would go back in and kind of redo this pose with by reworking the shapes and things if it wasn't quite to where I wanted it to be. I think it's gonna be good. This is his machete. We'll give it a little character. Maybe he's had to tape it up there. Make it look like it's been worn and used. It's had a little bit of a life to it. And we can just kind of picture in our minds what some of those adventures were like as he uses some of his tools here. Each tool should have a story to it. And we don't have to know each and every story. We can just leave it up to our imagination. I think his arm is a little too fat right there. Make his sleeve poke out like that. Oh, looks like I have a question on Instagram. Who is your favorite preacher living? Favorite living preacher. Well, that is a good question. I think your own pastor should be your favorite preacher. But I'm assuming you're looking for, I don't know, big name preachers or something. And let's see, I haven't really listened lately to any preachers. So I don't know that I can give a very good answer to that. So when I listen to someone, I want my goal is to hear them exposit the word. And so when I get that question, I think of who is an excellent expositor of God's word, who takes the text and really brings out what the original authors intended for it to mean, and who is clear and helpful in their explanations. Of people like that, and I don't really know that I could really name just one. Who's your favorite? Let's start there. Let me think about that. It's gonna take me a while to think. about that. I am a slow, slow thinker, just so you know. Okay, so my goal with these drawings is to make sure that they are ready for me to add the final line art. They don't have to be super perfect. They can be sketchy lines because I'm going to go over them when I lay in the inks or the black line art. So there's no need for them to be super crazy, intense, super detailed. Because I'll add the detail in when I do I just wanted to make sure I was actually streaming on YouTube. Here we go. Alright. Oh, that's what I'm missing. His nose. Nostrils, at least. And his eyebrows. His eyebrows just float. I like that. Gives them kind of their own character. I feel like it helps his expressiveness because it exaggerates his expressions a little bit more. Okay. I went from this rough sketch here. Well, actually, if you want to be technical, I went from this rough sketch. Okay. So this was my rough sketch here. Then cleaned it up a little bit. And you can see I didn't have the shape quite right here, or how I wanted it, because this one flows a little bit more. And so, actually, I don't know if you could even see that. So, I went ahead and I redrew it to fit more of how I wanted it to be, which is not how you should interpret scripture. Difficult to hear you, brother. Thank you, Jeremiah. I'm not projecting my voice very well. Is that better? Let me know. I also have a fan on. Let me turn that off. That's probably there. How's that? Is that better? My apologies. I have no air conditioning in this room, so it gets super hot, and it's supposed to get up to like in the 80s today here in Wisconsin. So I have my fan running. Hopefully you can hear now. So yeah, I got to this final version of the sketch, and now I will show you how I turn that into a finished ink drawing. And then we'll go through and we'll do that with the other ones as well. I want to at least get to it right now. So I just grab my ink brush and I just start tracing. It's kind of tracing. When I'm not doing something that requires filled in black artwork, like these eyebrows require them to just be completely filled in, and so when I'm not doing like that, I like to go like thick to thin on my lines just to give them some variety, to give them a little bit of life. And typically, like your thicker lines are going to be on your on the underside of things, so like under his jaw here, it's a thicker line, and then on top, it's a thinner line. So anywhere you have like this tension, so like there's tension up here, so it's gonna be a thick, thinner line going down to thick. So like at your kneecaps, it's gonna be a lot thinner, because if you or even your elbow. When that tension on the skin makes it really tight right there, that's typically where I do the thinner lines, and then under here would be like a thicker line. So that's kind of a the basics of weighted lines. I used to love studying the illustrations of Bill Watterson in Calvin and Hobbes, and I just loved how he drew his trees, and his lines were always go thick to thin. Sometimes he would have like super thick lines too. I'm not sure how to pronounce that name. Kyan Kin says, "I love this. Thank you. Appreciate it." Oh, and I just. Well. Probably seeing stuff move on the screen right now. I totally messed something up here. Have some docs in my streaming software here. And I took one of the windows out of the dock and now it's just floating and it's kind of driving me crazy now. And I can't get it to go back in. Oh, and now I just lost it. Okay. So. I don't know what's going on. One second, I have to fix something here. Oh, there it is. This is all messed up. You guys, I am not good at this technology thing. There we go. Alright. That was a rabbit trail. So anyways, back to this. Sorry for you, those of you on Instagram, you can't see the screen that I was working on, so I was having to fix where my chat pop-ups were coming up. So there we go. All right, thick to thin to thick. That's how it goes. And can't remember what all my shortcut buttons are. There we go. And super thin line there. We'll do a thin line there because that's the blade. And close that. Bring this down here. And we're going to close that off with like the shape of the panel here. I don't have that all laid out yet. Oh, yep, it's just a matter of going through, cleaning up the image with some black line art. And then moving on to the next stage. Oh boy. That's way too thick of a line. All right, and that is how it goes. So now we have a finished line art of this character here. And then I'll move on to the other ones, clean up the sketch, and then move on to the line art. Augustine has gotten over halfway to his destination. For those of you on Instagram, this is what I'm referring to. I have Augustine, an Augustiner, and he, once he reaches the Council of Nicaea, our time is done. So, we have a question here. Hold on, I can't see it. Oh, Dan on Facebook says, I've not seen this screen look before. What are you using to give your video screen this look? I am using OBS Studio, which is a streaming video production program. It's free, open source program, and I am just using a lot of different elements and plugins in order to give it this look. So yeah, this one I'm going to ink because I'm happy with the way the drawing has turned out, the sketch. So I would like to zoom in. Sometimes I get a better line when I am zoomed in like this. This is like super zoomed in. But sometimes it offers me a better line. If I'm zoomed out, the line tends to be a little thicker than I would like it to be. Instagram keeps cutting out, and I wonder if it's because I'm using my phone and not my iPad to live stream on it. Thank you, Dan. Yeah, I've been trying to make the video production on these live streams a little bit more bearable than just my screen and a video of my face. So I hope that it's working well, and I have some other ideas of different ways to improve the stream as well. I'm learning some motion graphics type of things, so I'm gonna try to get some animated titles and things. So here we are so far. We have this and this. You know, I may have to end this before Augustine gets to Nicaea, because I am hot. It's like a sauna in here. I cannot really breathe very well. Whew. It is a humid heat up here. this is what I have so far. And I just want to thank everyone for tuning in. Wisco, Michael Skinner. Yes, Wisco. I'm in Wisconsin. The Great White North, which is like super hot right now. Great White North, meaning it snows a lot. Just thought I'd clarify. Dan says, we've taken a few trips to Wisconsin this year, so when we pass by your area, I wave. I thought I sensed a disturbance in the force. A few days this year. I had the sudden urge to wave towards I-90. Awesome. Well, I'm calling it a stream, and this is what I have so far. I'm trying to work on these slowly but surely. I have a lot of other work that gets in the way of this project and creating new RefToons, but hopefully I can weed out some things and get back into this a little bit more. I have a few more projects on the horizon that are going to take a lot of time, but one of those I should be able to live stream with it, so you can kind of see what's going on in the world of RefToons. And I hope to have some more of the regular tunes to post, some new ones. Right now I've just been recycling a lot of the old ones for people who have maybe just found RefToons, and so they haven't seen like some of the earlier ones, so I've just recycled those each week. I've been posting the Westminster Catechism questions each day as well, so you can check those out and go to RefToons.com and pre-order the Westminster Catechism. Once we reach 600 pre-orders, I'm going to add in a decal with every order as well, a Westminster decal. So I'm looking forward to that, looking forward to getting those into your hands, and the print company is pretty backed up, so we're looking at maybe possibly an October release where we can actually ship them out to you. So thank you all for tuning in, and I will see you next time.